쓰치네. All right, where's the slippers? What? Ladies and gentlemen, Fido has just told me, in strictest confidence, that he was so stoned that he could not keep the slippers in his mouth. Fido, you must be punished for this. I asked you, I was nice to you, I feed you not a speck of cereal, and you reward me by not bringing those slippers. Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ! Fido, you're in for it tonight. This is New York. They want violence, brutality, perversion. Fido, you're in trouble. Okay, step number one. Step number two. Step number three. And the dog is unquestionably sick. Dog. This son of a bitch had hair evenly distributed all over it. Small, piquant, charming, canine-type funny. It looked like all the other dogs. It was a nice dog. It didn't look like it had a funny haircut like this one. The modern contemporary disco poodle of your dreams. Then, God made two other mistakes. Mistake number two was roughly entitled Man. And mistake number three, guess what? It was called Woo Man. Well, this gets pretty deep. Let me organize myself. Now, the Woo Man looked upon the poodle with lust in her heart. And then she looked at the man and she knew right away that the man was a chump, you see. And that's why she turned to him and said in a very nice way, so as to induce him. She said, sucker, go get a job. And he immediately got up off of his booty, left the garden of Eden, went out and got a job pushing a broom for about $1.298 an hour. He came back, gave his money to the Woo Man. The Woo Man took the money. She left the garden of Eden and went directly to the nearest hardware store, got herself a pair of clippers, some scissors, and a pair of zircon-encrusted tweezers, and came back and did a J-O-B on the D-O-G, if you know what I'm talking about. She cleaned off all across his back here, really nice, got him on the thorax, did his medulla carefully, little work right around Limerick City here. Then she trimmed the legendary snout of the aforementioned poodle, being careful to reveal the succulent, moist, and delightful little black teeny-weeny poodle lips. Then she took the dog and put him over by the side like this. She went over and she sat on his face. And somehow, I don't know how she managed to do this, but even in that position, the woo man was able to look deep into the poodle's eyes and say these words.
Show me a thumb if you really dumb. Show me a thumb if you really dumb. Show me a thumb if you dumb. Let's play this. Thank you.
some prince eats a steaming pig in a chamber right near there. Yeah, he eats the snouts and the trotters first. The loins and the groins are soon dispersed. His carving style is well rehearsed.
Thank you. Yeah. You're the one.
Where's what I started to hear. Then I heard this noise like a punching twig, and up jumped the devil horse. This big, he had a red snarl and a widow's feet, and then a fiery tail like a sober. Cause it was all night, I swear to God it was. He had some human flesh stuck underneath his claws. You know it looked to me like it was teddy skin. I said, you son of a bitch, cause I was mad at him. So he just got out his claws and started cleaning his fangs. So I shot him with my shooter, said, bang, bang, bang. The sucker just laughed and said, well,
put it away, you know I ain't a holler. Now what you gonna say?
You ate my crystal.
Yeah, titties and all.
Well, what about the beer then?
I would have cans this song.
Even her boots.
No, but I lied to you.
Shit, you must have been hungry.
Yeah, this is true.
Well, don't they pay you good? I mean, it's a civil service job for what you do.
Well, you know I can't complain when the checks come through.
I want my crystal, you know, yeah. I want my beer. You just boot her back out. Now, would you hear?
Listen. Blow it out your ass, motorcycle man. I mean, I am the devil. Do you understand? Just what will you give me for your titties and beer? I suppose you noticed this little contract here.
You're goddamn right, you son of a
whore.
That's about the only reason I learned writing porn. Give me that paper. You can bet your ass outside. Because I need a beer and it's titty squeezing
man. Yeah.
Well, let's make a deal if you think that's true. I mean, you're the devil. What you gonna do?
Wait a minute now.
Come on.
You wanna make a deal with me?
Sure, I'm such a deal. Let's
that's
make a deal.
Switch.
Look.
Now wait.
Let me put it to you very bluntly. You can have my soul.
You want me to take
it? It's a mean little sucker about 1,000 years old.
At all, huh?
And once you get it, you can't give it back.
Oh,
you
no.
have to keep it forever. And that's a natural
wait,
path. Because I want beer.
Wait, there's
and
some
I want
in this
beer.
Wait,
and then I want some beer.
Beer.
And then I want hockey.
Wait a minute, man.
And then I want football,
wait
beer.
Wait
and I want hockey.
No, wait, I don't know about
what you're
hockey,
now,
man.
Baseball.
I
want beer. I want a t-shirt with straps like this. I want my stomach to go way out really far. And then I want some tits. I want tits like this. I want some broadband tits.
No!
I want a principal style. Give me some beer.
Give me some tits.
The world, she said.
I got this free beer because it's a bullet down. And I'm gonna get drunk from this hockey clown.
She gave us the finger and was rigid to sip. That's when the devil, he farted and she went right over the cliff.
Oh, wow, this is the best night I've ever been on.
Gosh, we had so much fun going down. The devil was mad, I took off to my head. This is also on the new album.
Bye-bye.
This is a song for lovers only. I know they have a lot of lovers in New York because many of them moved here from Virginia. Which is about the only way you're going to get them. By the way, where are those titties and where's that beer?
Yeah.
The name of this song is Black Napkins.
Thank you.
listen to this. I was in Philadelphia for the last 2 days. And the day before yesterday, I went on the Mike Douglas show. It's going to be on November 10th. And I played this song with Mike Douglas's studio orchestra. It's a good thing they were all Italians.
Thank you. The next thing I knew, we had a
too.
Wahoo, wahoo.
Thank you. Say goodbye.
Bobby, say goodbye.
Patrick O'Hearn, Terry Bozio, Eddie Johnson, Bianca. Thank you very much for coming to the concert. Hope you enjoyed it. Happy Halloween warm up to you. Gentlemen, I want to dedicate this song to an old friend of mine, a guy I met while I used to live here, but I'm sure that he'll appreciate this song. This goes out to Bleeker Bob. This song was originally recorded by the Jayhawks on the Flash label in 1956 and then covered by the Cadets. And eventually it was re-recorded by the New York Dolls. The name of this song is Stranded in the Jungle. Meanwhile, back in the jungle, the boys in the jungle had me on the run when something hit me, hit me like an atomic bomb. When I woke up and my head started to clear, I had a strange feeling I was in cooking gear. Before I turned around and I looked to see, that's when I found out there was a crooked bee. Let me out here! Meanwhile, back in the States, meanwhile, back in the jungle, I jumped out of the pot and I finally got away, frantic with worry about what my baby'd say. So I jumped in the ocean and I started to swim, but my chances of survival were getting mighty slim. So I thumped out my whale who was in my way, and I reached the States in about a half a day. Now when I got to Lover's Lane, I was almost dead. My soul was gone, and here's what I said. Baby, baby, man's so good. Oh, baby, baby, should I should. We got this other song. It just happens to be in the same key. It's a slow song. We don't usually like to play slow songs for encore material because I know you guys don't want to get your rocks off in a hurry here. but this is something that I think you'll enjoy. The name of the song is What's a Girl Like You Doing in a Place Like This? New York, how'd you get there? Nice dress. Tell me where
I left my plane after midnight, and I came to this home. Me and my girlfriend came in looking to bomb.
You came to the right place. Well, this is it. This is the swing.
Octopus and speaker phone with cream corn.
Doesn't everyone?
Well, my girlfriend gets it with a white mouth Gatorade bottle, while someone in the background could be screaming, you know what I mean?
Child. slipping my thumb in a pipe, both takes a bruise in the blood. I poked and slipped and my wrist got numb. Still didn't hear no dynamo, huh? No dynamo, huh? Perspiration on her upper lip area. And she said, listen to this, she said, just get your waist in the middle of it, halfway to the left. If my mind's full up, if my mind don't care, I rub my chinny chin chin and said, my, my, my. What sort of thing would make this lady mine? The $40 bill didn't matter no more. Sister got naked and laid on the floor. She said, dynamo man, win the bet, but she could use a little. If I wasn't done yet, I told her, gently call the sun, what a place in the sky. No reason to assume I would give her a try. So I pulled on her hair and got her legs up in the air, and I asked her if she had any cooties in there.
What you mean, cooties?
I was buns up dealing. I was wheeling and dealing.
Wheeling and dealing.
You can't. Thank you.